गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टडी अबाउट काइंड्स ऑफ टेबल्स, अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टेबल्स. द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टेबल्स कैन बी डन ऑन थ्री बेसिस. व्हाट आर द थ्री बेसिस? These are according to purpose. On the basis of what purpose you have created the table. These are called the classification according to purpose. If we go further, it can be classified into two parts or two types. First, general purpose table. What is general purpose table? It is the table which is used as or for general purpose. It means there is no specific reason for that. These are just the data bank. What these tables are called? These are called the data bank. This is made just to collect the data and to arrange the data. These tables do not have any special objective of making. Many tables are there which are made just as a part of any other study, just like when we do the census of India. So many reports are attached with the census of India as tables. All these are called the general tables or the reference tables. Then the second one is specific purpose table. These tables are made for any specific purpose. It means for any specific reason, for a specific cause, we study the data. We have the purpose in our mind that why we are going to create the table. So these are called the specific purpose table. Now we come to the second category, that is according to originality. How much original our table is, that is according to originality. First one is original table. It is a table in which data is original. It means it is presented in the same form or same manner, or we can say it is presented as it is without any kind of classification, without any kind of changes. As we collected, we organize the data in a table. That is called the original table. Then the second type is derived table. Derived table are the tables in which data is not presented originally. It means it is derived. We collect the data and then we change the data into ratio, into percentage, or any other points of our convenience, and then we note down the data in the table. So the data is not original, it is derived from the original data. So these type of tables are called derived table. So these are the first two types, the according to purpose and according to originality. For the purpose, general purpose table or the data bank, these are the tables which are created not for any special reason, they are just created so that that can be used anywhere, wherever we require. Specific purpose table, these are the tables which are made for any special purpose. When we made these tables, we have the purpose or the target in our mind. Then the original table, in which the figures or the data is original. It means as we have collected, we present the data in the table. Then we have the derived table, in which the data is derived from the original data. It means that original data is presented as is converted, changed in the ratio, in the table, in the percentage or in any other way, and then it is written in the table. So that is called a derived table. Now we come to the last and the most important type of change, that is according to construction. By the way we construct the table, it can be divided into two ways. First one is simple table, or it is called one way table. The other division is complex table. Now complex table, it can be divided further into different parts. These are double table, treble table, and the manifold table. Now it is very much clear by the name itself. Simple table, it is the table which is made simply, which has just simple two columns. The data is presented in those two columns. Then the complex tables, in which we have two folds, that are called the double table. Where we have the three folds, these are called the treble table. And when we have the more than three folds, that is called the manifold table. Now we will see how to construct these tables according to construction, that how these formats change. First we see the simple table. Whenever we are required to make a simple table, what we do, first we would write the table number, then the our heading, subhead. We should write all these things, and then suppose I start with table number 4. This is the table number. Then topic of the table, suppose number of students in school. Okay. Now there is no need for any subhead or any other, so we will make the table itself. In school we have classes, so class and number of student, class 12th, 11th, 10th, 9th, 8th. If we have the section, then we can write the sections as well. Number student 50, 60, 30, 40, 35, 42, 58. So this is how we can create a simple table. we just write the table number and the other formalities, and then the data is classified into two groups. Simply, these are called the simple tables. Now we move forward to the complex tables. The first one is double table. In double table, suppose we are going with the same data. Now, how to make a double table? Table number 4, number of students in school class number of students now here boys girls what we have done we have divided the data in two groups boys and girls here we divide one column number of students into two columns so this is called the double table 12th 11th 10th and then we can take the rest figure suppose in class 12th we have 40 boys and 10 girls here we have 50 boys and 10 girls here we have 30 boys and 5 girls and rest we can write the number further this is called the double table now we move to the triple table in the triple table we divide the data into three categories just like table number 4 number of students in school then first we write class and number of students classes and the number of students now as we are going to make the triple table what we do we divide the number of students in different groups these are boys girls and total now what we have done here 12th 11th 10th 9th 8th now see what we have done here we have divided number of students column in three categories boys girls and total so here we can see that here we have three columns this is called the triplet table when we have the column more than one or more than two it means when we have the three columns or we divide a single column into three parts then we call it a triple table now we can note down the figures 40 boys 10 girls 50 30 boys 10 girls 40 30 boys, 5 girls, 35. Suppose we have 40 boys, 12 girls, 52. We have 30 boys, 30 girls, 60. So this is how we can write the data in these type of tables. Then we have the manifold tables. Manifold tables, these can be divided into here in more than three columns or mean in many folds, just like when we talk about if we divide this data into manifold table, what we do? Class number of students. Now we divide these into boys, girls and total. When we do in this way, now see how the things changes. When we keep it as class and number of students, it is a simple table. When we introduce boys and girls, it became double table. When we introduce the new column of total, it became triple table. Now what we do? We divide these boys, girls and total further as urban boys, rural boys. Urban girls, rural girls. Then we have the total mein urban total and the total of rural students. Okay, or you can divide these furthermore whenever you require. But when you have these type of division, this is called the manifold table. Now we write down 12th, 11th, 10th, 9th, 8th. Suppose we have the total number of boys 40 out of 30, 10. We have the total girls 10. 10 come from urban, 10 come from rural area. Now there are total 40 students. Out of these, 30 come from urban and 10 come from rural area. Five girls and five boys. Out of 30, 10 girls and 20 boys. Then we have 35, 10 from rural, 25 from urban, five girls, five boys. Maybe we have 6 boys and 4 girls here. Then 20 out of 25, we have 15 girls from urban area and 10 boys from urban area. Then in class 9th, we have 52 students. So maybe possible that 32 from urban rural area and 20 from urban area. So 10 boys and 10 girls from urban area and 22 boys and 10 girls from rural area. Then we have 60 students, 40 from rural area and 20 from urban area. Maybe 5 boys from urban area and 15 girls from urban area. In the same way, वी हैव 40 स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम रूरल एरिया, 20 बॉयज एंड 20 गर्ल्स. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ टेबल्स आर कॉल्ड मैनीफोल्ड टेबल्स इन विच डेटा इज कलेक्टेड इन टू मेनी डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज. सो दिस वॉज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टेबल्स अकॉर्डिंग टू their originality, according to their construction, according to their purpose. So this is all for today. Next time when we meet, we'll study about the classification of data and the presentation in table, how to represent the data in table, and then we'll solve some questions related to this. Thank you.